Good Saturday evening. Gracie Dinkos here with your local forecast update. Let's go ahead and look at that radar right now. It's pretty active across central Alabama as those storms just move north, northeast into our area. We are seeing some here in Bibb County and Tuscaloosa County, as well as Chilton County, some stronger storms in Bibb County, bringing some lightning associated with those heavy rainfall. So if you hear thunder, go indoors. If we jump over to Tuscaloosa, Cam, outside of Bryant-Denny Stadium, temperature of 72. That rain has cleared. It did come in earlier, but it quickly moved past. We're going to continue to see that pattern all throughout the evening. If we look at the temperatures now, they have dropped drastically from our high today. 72 in Tuscaloosa, 72 in Haleyville, and 74 in Birmingham. And those areas up to our northern counties, Coleman and Gadsden, they did see a little bit more rain this afternoon and continue to see more rain. If we look at the big picture here, we can see this low pressure system sitting over Arkansas and Missouri area, and it's just pushing some of that rain and unsettled weather towards us, and it's going to continue to push over us and then become stalled over our area. So let's track this out for you for Saturday night. This evening, we're going to see rain continue to pass through our counties, and into the overnight hours, we're going to get some more rain in the morning as well. This rain is going to be widely scattered tomorrow. Some of us may see heavier rain. If we see right here, Sunday afternoon, most of that heavy rain is going to stay to our eastern counties, but we do see Tuscaloosa getting some good amount of rain as well. Sunday night, rain's still going to stick around. Some areas may see a break here and there, but for the most part, it's going to be a wet day. Monday, same story. Monday evening, we're seeing widespread rain. If we look at the rain accumulation just in the next 24 hours, we see half an inch for Tuscaloosa and other areas seeing almost an inch of rain. We jump another 24 hours ahead into 48 hours from now. Many of us are seeing at least 1 inch of rain across central Alabama, if not an inch and a half of rain. Something to be aware of if you are in low-lying areas, that rain could build up and stay stagnant and cause some localized flooding. If we look at the rain chances for the next 5 days, now I know you're wondering, when do we get a break from this? And not for a long time from now. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, we're expecting lots of rain. And Wednesday, rain is still in the forecast, but it's going to decrease just a bit by Thursday. That low pressure is still going to be in our region, but it's going to be pushing out of our region, bringing us some nicer weather, maybe a little bit more dry weather. Tonight, our overnight low is going to be around 70 degrees, mostly cloudy skies, and possibly some thunderstorms around with some calm winds. If you're going out to watch the race tomorrow in Talladega, it's not going to be a beautiful day like this one, that's for sure. We're going to see mostly clouds and overcast conditions, possible thunderstorms and showers for most of the day. Let's look at that extended forecast, though. The rain is not going anywhere for a while. We do see a good chance to see some rain tomorrow and into Monday and Tuesday as well. By Wednesday, that decreases just a bit. We'll still see a few storms across the region. By Thursday, those become isolated, and into Friday as well. By Saturday, we're going to dry up, see more sunny conditions, and those temperatures do fall into the low 70s and upper 70s by midweek.